It's Erica again. So in the last video, we talked a little bit about how to browse through academic journal articles based on your major area of interest or a subject area that you're interested in and start to recognize how these functions or examples of these functions appear in some of these academic journals. In this video, what we're going to do is actually go into some of the library databases and start from scratch with some keyword searching based on your areas of interest. I'm actually going to show three different examples across a couple of different databases because I know that a lot of the topics in this class, you guys are coming at this from different perspectives. Some of you are business majors and you're interested in questions related to that. Some of you are biology majors and you maybe want to try to pick a topic that's related to that. There's probably a way to connect your major or an area of interest to this particular topic, and you've likely already discovered that with some of the work that you started to do. So, a couple of things I want us to keep in mind as we turn to our databases, and we'll jump to the library homepage in just a second. The first thing that you need to do to think about as far as like picking which database that you want to search is, what subject area am I working in? So for example, if you're a business student and you're focusing in on a business related topic, we're going to pick the subject database Business Source Premier. Likewise, if you're a biology student, Medline is a good database to pick from. So think about the subject area and then use our database filters to help narrow down which one you're going to choose. So we'll look at three different ones depending on the subjects, and we'll do a search in each one of those, and then you can contact me with questions. Let's head to the library homepage. All right, so I am on our library homepage, and just a quick reminder, you get here by going to www.gordon.edu/library. And as I scroll down on this page, one of the things that I want to encourage you to do is actually start from the course guide that we have created for your class. So I'm going to head there on our library homepage. Scroll all the way down to the bottom to the orange research box and then click on Research Guides. Once you're in this landing page for the major subject areas that we offer at Gordon, go ahead and click on Mathematics and then Math 134. So here, looking at your subject guide, and what I want you guys to do is click over to the Databases tab, and you'll start to see a little bit about what I'm talking about, where we separate our databases by subject area. So I mentioned we're going to be exploring three different examples in different subject areas, and we'll use different databases to help us answer that question. Let's go ahead and start with a business example. So notice on my database page here, I have a couple of different options, and the best source for business is Business Source Premier. So go ahead and click right on that. And when you open this up, you're in the Business Source Premier database. And now here's where we want to enter some of our keywords. So no matter what topic you're exploring, keyword selection is really important. And one of the ways that I like to think about searching for this particular project is, think of your keywords in terms of the variables of your function. What are the two sides of it? What's that rate of change that you might be exploring? And those are often good search terms to look at. Let's say we are interested in exploring how online retail is impacted by purchase behavior of our customers. So we're gonna go ahead and enter in a couple of different keywords here. The first thing I'm gonna do in my top term is enter in that term, online retail. And I'm actually gonna build in a synonym term. And what I mean by synonym term is a similar or like term that we can actually search with at the same time. And to do that, I'm gonna write in my search operator or. So I wanna do online retail or online marketplace. And then what I want to do is, my second line down, I want to select my secondary term that I'm searching with. And that was purchase behavior or consumer behavior. So effectively what we're asking our search results to do is search for either of these terms. We could get online retail and purchase behavior, we could get online retail and consumer behavior, and so on. Trying to make our keywords do a little bit of work for us. Don't forget that when we're searching in a library database, one of the most important things about searching a database is how easy it makes us to filter our results by scholarly peer-reviewed research. So you're only getting those articles that are published in those academic journal articles like I showed you in the first video. And then scrolling down here at the bottom of Business Source Premier database, one of the other things that can be really helpful is limiting your results to articles that have this image quick view down here. This ensures that the articles that you're looking at has a graph in it, or a chart, or a diagram, or maybe an illustration. information so that we can start narrowing down our results a little bit as we go. So I'm going to select those limiters and go ahead and click search. All right, so for my first pass, I get about 280 results, which is not a bad place to begin. So what I'm going to do as far as selecting an article is I'm glancing first at the title of the articles to see how relevant they are to the topic I'm interested in, but I'm also taking a look at these image quick views that I pulled into my search to see if I'm getting close to maybe some graphs or data that might be helpful as far as using as that example in my functions essay. Let me go ahead and jump into this first one as an example, consumer search and filtering on online retail platforms. And when you're on here, I'd recommend that you pop open the full text of the PDF or whatever full text version you have of it. And then as you scroll through, later on you'll read the article in more detail, but as you scroll through, we can already start to see some examples of what it is that we're looking for. Graph data like this. And then if we scroll down, we get even additional information like equations and things like that, as well as further types of graph information that can be useful pulling into our functions essay, such as this one. So these are all different examples of things that you might use. So this is a business example, searching within Business Source Premier. All right, let's go ahead and do another search. I'm gonna go back to your Math 134 course guide. And now let's go ahead and take a look at a question that's coming from our biology resources. And I'm gonna, to do this, I'm actually gonna click on my database, Medline. Medline is a great database for questions about the biomedical field, health journals, healthcare professionals, nurses, clinicians, all sorts of different things related to that topic area. A couple of things I want you to notice about this search. First, this looks really similar to Business Source Premier, right? It effectively looks like the exact same database, but notice please at the top, it says searching Medline. So we are in a different resource, and this is focusing specifically on articles within that field of study. So let's once again go ahead and enter in some keywords. And what I'll remind you again, think about these as far as their variables. Let's say we wanted to look at the infection rate or spread of disease within a particular disease. And we'll go SARS for right now. So we're searching by that virus first, and then for my second term down, we wanna look at the infection rate. So that's one of our terms. Or we're also gonna say spread of disease. Once again, select that scholarly peer-reviewed checkbox. Notice this time when we scroll down, we don't have those handy image filters, but that's okay. We can still open up the PDFs and take a look. Alrighty, so as I'm scrolling down through here, I'm glancing at the titles that will be most helpful as far as actually tracking like a rate of change or something like that. And I notice this one down here that says, estimating number of cases and spread of the corona disease in the UK. And this is a pretty recent article. So I'm actually gonna go ahead and click on that one. And one of the things that I wanna call your attention to is, over here in the details record section, we no longer have that handy PDF link, but we do have something called Full Text Finder. Whenever you see a link like this, just click on Full Text Finder and follow the trails of research from wherever it's directing you to go. Usually when you get directed to this full text link page, you want to click on the little icon that looks like a piece of paper. In this case, I actually found one of our articles in PubMed Central, so we're going to go ahead and click on that. And there it is right there. We can open up the PDF. And that's something that we're used to seeing. So once again, if we were to scroll down through here, we see there's graph data that we could potentially pull in, there's equations, all that kind of stuff. Let's go ahead and see one more example. Let's say you wanted to look at something in the music field. Maybe some of you are music majors. Now notice on this particular database page, I don't have one database that says music in it. This is where I want to introduce you to a database that all of you can use no matter what subject area you're focusing on, and that is Academic Search Ultimate. Some of you may have already encountered this database before. It is our largest multidisciplinary database that we have. No matter what topic you're exploring for your functions essay, Academic Search Ultimate will have something for you. So let's continue with our idea of music, and once again enter in some keywords. Let's say we wanted to look at how a live concert performance is impacted by the audience's sound or audio or something along those lines. We have a keyword of performance or live concert. That's our first variable. Then we want to do and audience. We're looking specifically at the correlation between the two, and then sound or audio and what impact that has. So we're gonna enter those keywords, we're gonna select our peer review checkbox, and then notice with this particular one, our image quick views are back. So once again, I'm gonna grab graph, chart, diagram, or illustration to help narrow down my results. Go ahead and click search. Let's click again into this top article as an example. We can choose to open up the full text of the PDF, or there's those image quick views over here in the corner demonstrating how these variables are related to each other and the different kinds of images that we actually might be able to pull in for the essay that we are writing. So I'm back on the homepage for your Math 134 course guide. I hope you found that useful. I hope that seeing a couple of different search examples through different databases has sparked your ideas about where you might head next. Your course guide contains a lot more information as well. You might have some links to some academic journals like the ones we looked at in the first video, some links to different data sites that might be helpful for you, ways in which we can view and manipulate our data to kind of see what we're talking about here as far as calculus functions, additional resources like that. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me. I'm always here to help.